In this video, we will solve problem 5. In this problem, you have to find out the bending energy of a hydrogen atom in the state of n is equal to 2. So the first question is, what is bending energy? Let us discuss about it. What is winding energy? What is bending energy? Then if I would give you a definition, then the first thing I would say, winding energy of a system, if you have any system, then the winding energy of a system is defined as the energy released when its constituent are brought from infinity to form the system. Or oppositely, we can say, if you have a system and the energy needed to separate its constituent to large distance, that you can say infinity. So you can say, like, in the first case, you can say that the energy that are released when its constituents are brought from infinity to form the system, right? Or you can say energy needed to separate its constituent to form large distances. So that is binding energy. The first definition, you can say energy released when its constituent, its means system, its constituent are brought from infinity to form the system. Or you can say its opposite, or you can say energy needed to separate its means system, separate its constituent to large distance. If you know this definition, then you can obviously solve the question. So if I say you have an atom, and what are the constituent of the atom? What are the constituents of the atom? So atom, that is electron, proton and neutron. And if I say you have a nucleus, that is nucleus. Then what are the constituents of the nucleus? That is neutron and proton. So you can solve this question. So you have to find the winding energy of hydrogen atom in the state n is equal to 2. So in the question 1, 2, 3, 4, we have come up with the expression for the total energy, that is En is equal to minus 13.6 Z square over N square. Now in this case, Z is equal to 1 and N is equal to 2. So if you find out the energy, that is E2, and E2 is minus 13.6, Z square is 1 and N square, that is 4. So it will be minus 3.4 electron volt. Now you have minus 3.4 electron volt energy in this state. Now what winding energy says? Energy released when its constituent are brought from infinity to form their system, or energy needed to separate its constituent. So system is already there. Now you have to separate them. And how much energy do you need? When you have to separate its constituent to a large distance, how much energy do you need? So to large distance, we have to find out the infinity. You have to find out the energy at infinity. So when n is equal to infinity, then what will be the energy? That is 0. So the energy that you are required, that will be 0 minus of 3.4. That will be 3.4 electron volt. That is your binding energy. So that's how you can approach this question. Thank you.